ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to another episode of ESTpm Recommends. Tonight, it's gonna get a little wild. It's gonna get a little crazy. It's gonna get a little bit blasphemous, because that's what we're playing. Blasphemous is a punishing action platformer that combines the fast-paced, skilled combat of a hack-and-slash game with a deep and evocative narrative core, delivered through exploration of a huge universe comprised of non-linear levels. The game is $24.99. It is developed by The Game Kitchen and published by Team 17 Digital Ltd. So with that, let's check out these options. So we see the game, accessibility, video, and sound. Under game, we have audio language, text language, show how to play, and controls. I'm not sure. Yeah, these are totally rebindable, apparently, which is really nice. I didn't think we'd be able to get that. Text language is English, show how to play, controls, accessibility, vibration. We'll turn that off. Screen shake, we'll keep that on. Video enabled VSync. We can disable that. Oh, 640 by 480. Whoa. That pixel perfect, 720 by 480. 800 by 600 pixel. Whoa. Pixel perfect there. So wait, these are like, I'm guessing if you want to play this on a CRT, you could do that. Yeah, you could totally play this on a CRT if you wanted to. That's fucking wild. Let's see. Yeah, if you want to play on a CRT, it's totally, I can even do 4K. We'll do 1920 by 1080. Sound all the way up. Some of the video options are pretty limited though, but it's a 2D platform. I don't expect anything too crazy or wild to go along with that. So let's get into Blasphemous.
Because it is my guilt, I claim your grievous miracle.
Oh no.
Make my chest hurt with regret.
Oh, this isn't gonna be good.
Forge your punishment and nail it deep.
Huh?
Shake my guilt once again.
Oh. I don't think that was a good... that's not a good look. Well, the artwork is fucking crazy. I'll give it that. Oh. Oh boy. It's really not what I expected. Oh.
Guilt, repentance, mourning, and every pain of the soul of all kind were visibly and tangibly manifested everywhere and in all of us.
Oh boy.
Sometimes in the form of blessing and grace. Sometime in the form of punishment and corruption. That divine will, equally pious and cruel, which we could not and will never be able to unravel, was called the miracle.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, that is a lot of bodies. My man hanging. Oh boy. This is apparently a mature game. Not for kids. Definitely not for kids. Brotherhood of Silent Sorrow. LB. There we go. Okay, yeah, just smash that on your face. Press LB to consume one of your biliary flasks to recover vitality. These consecrated flasks are filled by kneeling in a pride, in a pre-dew. Find empty vessels to increase the amount you can carry. Okay. As with any game, we always go to the left first. Nothing. Just a ton of bodies and these fucking wild-ass hats. These hats are wild, man. There are a lot of dead bodies. I feel like I'm going to be seeing a lot of that in this game. Just a ton of just bodies everywhere. A for jump. Oh, there's a slide. Okay. Animation in here is really fucking crazy. Okay, cool. That's what exactly what I thought it was going to be. This is turning out like Castlevania, really. Press Y to rest at a pre-due, saving your game and refilling your health and flasks. Upon death, you will respawn at the very last visited pre-due, visiting... I can't read. Resting will cause enemies to respawn. Okay, so similar to Dark Souls. Alright, let's keep... Yeah, break those lights. There we go. Oh, what is that? Uh-oh. We're doing a boss fight first thing. Ow, fuck. Fuck on that. Can't handle me, boy. Requiem Aeternum. So yeah, there's a lot of Dark Souls influence in this, I can tell. Oh boy. What are you doing? What are you doing, my dude? Oh no. This is gonna be one of those games, huh? Oh boy. I'm in for a roller coaster, huh? Yep. This is gonna be a thing. Oh, what on earth?
Regretful be the heart, penitent one. The anguish of the eldest brother has now come to an end. I am Deo Gracias, witness to and narrator of the acts of the grievous miracle. Such is my penance, as yours is silence.
She's got a penance.
The cradle of affliction is what you seek. This can be found in the mother of mothers of the churches.
Oh boy.
It is a remote place separated from the rest of these lands by a great sacred and forbidden door.
This is the thing.
Even a wise penitent like me knows nothing of what lies beyond those high walls. However, what I do know is that, according to the rule, one must carry out the three humiliations to gain access to what they guard.
Three humiliations?
Must be performed in the high mountains, covered in thick blankets of snow and ice. Another, in the depths of a dark, entombed church where the sleeper lies. And the last one, at the end of the trail, carved by moans that claw their way out of an iron spiral.
Jesus.
In the bowels of the bell named Hondo that grows into the earth. Take this thorn and place it on the handle of your sword. If, when the time comes, as you grip your weapon firmly, you notice that it wounds you and makes you bleed.
Oh, Jesus.
Having grown, with more thorns sprouting from it, writhing over the figure of the father carved into the knob.
Mm-mm.
That will mean that you are at the mercy of the grievous miracle, whether for its punishment or its forgiveness.
Oh, good. A thorn to bust into my fucking hand. Check items you found so far in your inventory while playing. Just open it.
Even a wise penitent like me knows nothing of what lies. However, what I do know is that a court sorrowful be the heart, penitent.
Alright, let's see. Oh! Oh shit, this is just like Castlevania. Okay, this is a pretty good... This is like a mix of Dark Souls, Castlevania. Oh man, this is gonna take up a lot of my time. This is gonna take up a lot of my time, I can already tell. Yep. This gonna be good. Press RB to parry. There it is. This maneuver allows you to counter weak attacks and deflect heavy strikes. During a counter, press the X button at the moment of impact to perform a retribution, increasing the force of the blow and stunning some enemies. Oh. There it is. There's the counter. Oh yeah, we are on it. This gonna be good. I'm already digging this game. You've acquired Viridialis of the Forsaken Hamlet. Use this prayer, open the inventory, and equip it. Song that filled the air during the festivities of a lost village. Its power finds its way through the floor, continues through the walls and ceilings, harming the enemies of the Penitent One. The ring of the laced shell horn used to precede this chant, but now only apply silence remains. Okay. Equip a prayer in your inventory and press LT to invoke it. Prayers and some combat techniques use a fervor. Attack and execute to use up or fill up your fervor bar. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Stunned him. So he gets stunned and I can do an execution. Oh, that's wild. Children of the Moonlight, you'll find them caged all over Custodia. You can release them with any technique at your disposal. Okay. 1 of 38. I wonder if I can stun him again. Alright, so they don't get stunned all the time. They only get stunned sometimes. This is a wild-ass game. This is a... Ooh, what is this?
There is no answer to our plea. The miracle has forsaken us, and my ornate throne turns its back on those who await here.
Alright, let's see here. Open your map. Yep, there it is. This is how we're gonna do it. Dude, this artwork is really cool, and I love the fact that you could do, like, pixel-perfect stuff.
Sorrowful be the heart, penitent one. Welcome to Albero, sanctuary to this humble brotherhood of the Kissers of Wounds.
Kissers of Wounds?
Few remain here who can still employ it, but Tirso is my name. There are few of us who still care for the sick and ailing. With devout kisses, we bless the wounds of those who seek our protection. Thus both we and they remain at the mercy of the miracle. Time outside these walls passes by strangely. In sundowns, we need not contemplate. But if your penance happens to carry you under said skies, be so kind as to bring us some ingredients for our ointments. The will in the miracle shall show you which ones they are.
The Dove Skull. Equip rosary beads in your rosary to improve the characteristics of the pendant one. Find additional knots to increase your number of beads you can equip. Equip that bitch. The skull of a bird and drilled as a collet. Its apparent frailness slightly strengthens the pendant's one's defenses. Okay. I'll take that. Slide. What the hell is this? I do not have a good feeling about this. That fucking helmet, though.
Penitent one, you who carry the painful guilt in your cracked hands. Lend it to us and alleviate our burden. Lend it to us and wipe away our tears.
What?
Because it is an act of penitence.
Oh, boy. Oh, no. The virtue of the mea culpa hath ascended. Oh, Jesus Christ. Visit the mea culpa shrines to increase the power of your sword. You can also spend tears of atonement to unlock combat techniques. Positional shrines to increase the mea culpa strength to access more powerful techniques. This game is, it's like hauntingly beautiful. Plunge attack. Dodge impulse to thrust mea culpa. Hold X while dodging. Concentrate the power of the mea culpa with a blade, allowing the pendant one to release its full potential in a single but incredible devastating attack. A fourth combo. We'll take that. Oh, it's 2,000. Fuck, I can't do that. We'll do the drop then. Bam. Damn, that looks good. That looks really good. Not gonna lie. There are so many influences from Castlevania.
Thou hast called upon the winch of the Order of the True Shrine. In this place, we gather the remains of those who were separated and forgotten, so we can grant them holy burial, as our charitable rule prescribeth. Help us these poor souls. O penitent one in silence, the Order blesses you.
Oh, wow. Phalanx of the Brannan, the Gravedigger. Brennan Joshua Mullins dug the graves of hundreds of throughout his life, whether their friend or family or foe, but when the chaos arose, there was one left. No one left to return the favor. Oh, wow. This is Phalanx? Dude. Wasteland of the Buried Churches. This game. Oh, fuck. I didn't time it. Oh. Oh. Ugh. Oh. Oh. Dude. I got. Ooh. It's got like a Diablo soundtrack. which I'm really digging. Oh wait, what's she doing down there? Can I get... No. Alright, let's go this way. Yeah, dude. This is like a Castlevania. Oh, boy. It worked. Whatever. That totally worked. Uvula of Proclamation? What in the Sam Hill? Okay, so here's like a quick fast travel back. I gotcha. I thought she was trapped, but she was really just a giant monster. That's fucked up. But I'm kind of digging it. Oh, wow. Oh. What's this? Capitate Barak of the Herald. Alright, let's see what the... Okay, anything else that I can use? When the evil is equipped, you have a chance of earning Tears of Atonement when destroying an object. Hell yeah! Oh! Jesus. Excommunications. Exemplaris. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is Blasphemous. Hope you enjoyed the video. I think this is going to be one of those games I beat very early this year. This is going to really sort of like suck me in and really put me in a situation where this is what I'm going to play for a long time. Press or trigger to dodge. Use the dodge action to crouch throughout small spaces. So this is going to be something I'm going to play for a while, I think. And then I'm going to have to do Bloodstain on top of that. So hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know what other games you want me to try on Steam Recommends. And we'll see you guys next time. Have a good one.